إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل فقد فاز المتقون وأذكركم ونفسي بقول الله تبارك وتعالى وإذ قال ربك للملائكة إني جاعل في الأرض خليفة قالوا أتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها ويسفك الدماء ونحن نسبح بحمدك ونقدس لك قال إني أعلم ما لا تعلمون. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With his divine support, we made it again today not to continue with the story of Luqman between him and his beloved son, the son that shows everyone who have been born how to be extension for your parents' life in the best manner. We will tell Luqman that we are not going far away from behind your door. We will not go too far because you are coming back to listen to what you have to say more to your son because you are orphans. And we need parents who will talk to us about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that they can put a purpose in our life and make us build our life on principles that will never die. We are going to leave Luqman's door and come back home to deal with the domestic violence that our planet is facing now. Violence at home is homemade, this earth. Allah made it for all of us to live in it and on it as a family, in peace, which is Salam, which is Islam. But that is not what happened. And the clue was in the ayah I just recited to you, the story of the beginning of man being placed on earth as a caretaker. The malaika did not oppose the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they had the clue due to the precedent that happened on earth through the jinn before Adam alayhi salam was placed on earth. And they opposed due to their full obedience. Will you place on earth someone who will cause mischief? And what type of mischief? Bloodshed on earth. While we are here glorifying you, praising you, and doing anything you want us to do. But Allah said to them, Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamun. I know what you know not. So there is violence at home. And we can see us bleeding all over the planet now. And the human blood became cheaper than the dirt, than the soil on earth that is soft with the innocent blood around our globe. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he spoke to the Arabs, his students, right in front of him. And sometimes due to the nature of the mischief that man will cause on earth, the Sahaba in front of him, who spoke the best Arabic, they could not understand what he said. When he said to them, لا تقوم الساعة حتى يكثر الحرج. The hour will not come. It means this world will not come to the end before this happened. Harj. And the Sahaba said, وما الحرج يا رسول الله. What is harj? They spoke Arabic. And that's why the Quran challenged them. Due to their ability and eloquence in Arabic. But this time, They could not know what Al-Hamd mean. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam explained and he said, Al-Qatl, Al-Qatl. Killing and killing and killing and killing non-stop. He didn't say death, because death is nature. When we die, we are practicing our nature. And no one will be charged because I died. When I die or you die, it's just like the ripe fruit dropping onto the earth. The farmer will not be upset or disappointed because it is time to drop. But killing is when the body has been destroyed while the soul is still in it. The fruit has been picked up before it is ripe. And that is corruption, that is mischief. But death, the soul is out, and then the body will become decomposed back to earth. So the Prophet said to them, Al-Harsh, killing and killing and killing by human beings to each other. This hadith in Sahih Muslim, and the other hadith in Sahih Muslim again say, but that time the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he confirmed what he was to say with Qasam and he swore, and he said, Walladhi nafsi biyadi, I swear in the name of whom is holding my soul, knowing that, وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ أَصَّدِقُ الْمَسْدُورِ, he is always truthful when he speaks. And he doesn't need to say Wallahi, but he said, for the Sahaba and for us to be aware what is on our way and what we will go through the course of life, as long we are holding on to what he gave to us as an amana, Islam. It will be burning us, but we are not allowed to drop it. So he said to them, وَالنَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِي لَا تَذْهَبُ الدُّنْيَا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ عَلَى النَّاسِ زَمَانٍ لَا يَدْرِي الْقَاتِلْ فِي مَا قَتَلْ وَلَا الْمَقْتُولْ فِي مَا قُتِلْ. This dunya will not finish before you see this. A time will come to mankind, there will be killing other people. But when you ask them why you are killing them, they don't know. And many will be killed without knowing why they have been killed. And we see this every day. When we turn on the news, in the TV, in the radio, on the newspaper, everywhere, we see us bleeding. And that is a winning card on the table of diplomacy nowadays, to win more votes using the people's ignorance about the mischief that has been planned by the enemies of humanity, the real terrorists, who not us talking bad about them, but their history talks bad about them. We know what they have done throughout life until today, using different blankets or different camouflage, and that is a pattern. Many people, and we can see us now in Syria, Muslims and non-Muslims are concerned what is happening in Al-Ghouta now. Children, elderly people, women whose houses has been knocked down and they survived out of the building, but the hijab is not knocked down. And she is waving to the man, don't touch me, I'm all right, while she is covered. These are the mountains of Islam. And a situation can never shake their deen and their belief and principles. That is the land of Sham. The final place when the world will even fight for water. No, they are fighting for petrol and so on. And they are killing. And they will and have to do this. Why? لِيَحْمِلُوا أَوْزَارَهُمْ كَامِلَةً يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَمِنْ أَوْزَارِ الَّذِينَ يُضِلُّونَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. For them to be charged fully
with their sins. And the sins of those who are following them blindly, killing people because they have been told to go and kill. But when the victim asking that soldier, "Why are you killing me?" "I don't know. I am doing the orders." Any order that is inviting us to destroy human life should be rejected if we are true soldiers. But it is happening. And the ayah meaning is clear. The hadith is very clear. And all of us now, we are sitting and waiting on the departure gate of this dunya, but without holding a boarding pass. Why we are not holding that? Because we don't know, and we don't have a clue about the nature of the vehicle that will take us out of this dunya. We don't know. And when? And the news every day to prove that. وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam never spoke because he wanted to speak. He only says what he was told to say. And he made sure he will never let nonsense come out of his mouth into our ears. Everything to give us life. Everything to keep us mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this dunya which he told us, لَوْ كَانَتِ الدُّنْيَا تُسَاوِي عِنْدَ اللَّهِ جَنَاهَ بَعَوْدًا مَا سَقَى مِنْهَا كَافِرًا شُرْبَةَ مَا If this dunya were before Allah, the wing of a mosquito, a non-believer does not deserve a drop of water. But this dunya worth nothing. And we can see the lovers of dunya, they will kill anybody on this earth if you are between them and what they want. And we know what they want. They want dunya. Through what? Through the petrol, the diamond, the gold, the land, and whatnot. But they are fighting for something that isn't worth it. And to explain the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, when he was telling us, you will die unprepared and without knowing why women have to see their 6 children all dead and she's still alive and she doesn't know why. Why is it? A family all has been destroyed and a child survived. Why is it? The poet of Iraq, Ahmad Matta, he explained the meaning of the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam when he said concerning about not knowing how and where and what vehicle will take us out of this world. And he made this imagination. Malakun kana fi babi sama yaftimu awraq al-wufud al-za'ira taliban min kulli atin nudhatan muhtasara an aradihi wa amman ahdar. We imagine Malakul Maud wondering how many lives have been taken. And this angel is welcoming those people who are entering the kingdom of the heaven. Or is stamping on their paper the entry visa into the kingdom of the heaven. But he wanted to know what caused your death. Who killed you? What happened? Qala atin ana min tilka al-qura. Someone said, I came from earth. Kuntu fi ta'ira mundu qalil ghayra anni qabla an yatrufa jafni jitu mahmulan huna fawqa shadaya ta'ira. Few minutes ago I was in an aeroplane, but within an eye blink I found myself here on the small pieces of the aeroplane. I found myself dead. قال آتي أنا من تلك القرى منذ ساعات ركبت البحر لكني أتيت محمولا على متن حريق الباخرة. This one said, I died in a different way. Few hours ago, I was on board on an ark, and all of a sudden, it caught fire. So the cause of my death was burning to death, and I found myself over here. قال آتٍ أنا من تلك القرى وأنا لم أركب البحر ولا الجو ولا أملك سعر التذكرة. I am from Earth. I did not board an aeroplane or a boat. I don't even have a ticket price. I'm a simple man. Home. كنت في نقاش أخوي في بلادي غير أني جئت مهمولا على متن رصاص المجزرة. I was having argument in my country few hours ago. And all of a sudden, mass killing, shooting everywhere, and a Muslim bullet got me and took my life out and sent me over here. قال آتٍ, someone else said, أنا من تلك القرى, I am from Earth. كنت من قبل دقيقة أتمشى في الحديقة أعجبتني وردة حاولت أن أقطفها فاقتطفتني وعلى باب السماوات رمتني لم أكن أعلم أن الوردة الفيحاء تغدو عبوة منفجرة. Few hours ago, I was walking around in a garden and I loved one flower and I went to pick it up. But instead, that flower picked me up. It took my life out. I did not know that a beautiful flower can be turned into explosive charge. So many ways they are killing the human beings, turning flowers into explosive devices for children to touch and die. قال آتٍ أنا من تلك القرى. Someone else said, I was on Earth. في انقلاب عسكري كودتا, overthrowing government, overthrowing another for junior purpose. And I was killed in that كودتا. في اجتياح أجنبي, foreigners invaded my country and they killed me to take over my land. حرب دائرة في بلادي, ongoing war in my country. أعمال عنف في كاراتشي, violence act in Karachi in Pakistan, and I died in that. قال آتٍ أنا من تلك القرى. Someone else said, I am from Earth. عبوة ناسفة, explosive device took my life away. طلقة قناص, a sniper shot me from far away. I don't know why. طعنة في الظهر, someone stabbed me from behind. I don't know why. Khamij, I was attacked through ambush. I don't know why. Thaab, blood, revenge, and they killed me, and I didn't kill anybody. Hizzatun ardiyatun fi Ankara, earthquake in Turkey in Ankara, and I died in that. This is the image of the vehicle taking us out of this world nowadays. And we can see it around us. And we are waiting for our turn. الملاك اهتز مذهولا وألقى دفترا أأنا أجلس بالمقلوب أم أني فقدت الذاكرة. أسأل الله الرضا والمغفرة إن تكن هذه هي الدنيا فأين الآخرة. The angel himself, the way they were confused when Allah said, I will create man on earth, he became shocked again. And he threw his paper away. Am I sitting upside down? Or I lost my memory? If this is this dunya, which worth nothing, and it is so violent, what about the akhirah? Will Allah ever forgive us for what we are doing to each other? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be content with us and to forgive us, but only when we play our role. All of us, have to become a spokespeople of our hurt as human beings. Praying 5 times a day, perfectly, not enough. Fasting Ramadan, perfectly, not enough. Reading the Quran Khatam, perfectly, not enough. Going to Hajj, paying zakat, not enough. We have to hold on to the amana. And we have to become a spokesman of the truth and cry for those who left this dunya and died, not to end, but to start a real life that starts with death. So the children of Syria, they are following their brothers and their sisters of Palestine, of Afghanistan, of Iraq. For them, the test is over. For us, it's just begun. And we don't know what is the thing we will do or say to contribute in saving the human life. If Islam was all about saving the human life and building the human life, anyone who is a true politician, true religious leader, true real citizen, this is the time to speak, not in violence, and we don't need anybody's acceptance or to entertain anyone, but only to tell the truth. And that is the only thing Allah wants from us, to stand up for justice. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ يَعِظُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah order بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ, towards justice and goodness. And if we cannot be just and good, we don't deserve to be on face of this earth. And all of these years He gave to us is for us to be what He intended us to be. A caretaker of earth, not a destroyer and not a mischief creator or man or woman full of corruption. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن الحكيم وجعلنا وإياكم من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. عباد الله, قال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انتصر للمستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انتصر للمستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انتصر للمستضعفين في كل مكان. وعليك بالتقاة الظالمين المعتدين فإنهم لا يعجزونك يا حي يا قيوم. يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل السفهاء منا ولا تؤاخذنا بما جرح السفهاء منا ولا تؤاخذنا بما قال السفهاء منا ولا تعاملنا بما نحن أهله وعاملنا بما أنت أهله. أنت أهل التقوى وأهل المغفرة. إن نظرت إلى ذنوبنا ومعاصينا فإنا نستحق العقوبة, ولكن رحمتك أعظم ومغفرتك أعم. فاغفرنا وارحمنا واشملنا برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء يا أرحم الراحمين. رحماك رحماك ربنا بالأطفال اليتامى والشباب الحيارى والنساء الثكالى. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين.
اللهم بك نسول وبك نجول وبك نجول وبك نقاتل أنت عددنا وأنت نصيرنا وأنت حسبنا وأنت رجاؤنا لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم فيما نزل بنا لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين وأقم الصلاة